Wanna know how to shut ass up? Hit that record button. Bam! Silence.
Silence. What's
the dread? Ooh, what the
fuck up? Bitch, you hate when you do your hair, bro, because you never know when to take that shit off.
My shit look good. I just got another compliment today. You a fucking hater.
My elbows are
It's Hawaiian silky.
What's going on, YouTube? It's me, Tiffany, and I'm here with my co-host, Tanea.
Hey, guys!
And we are back with an all-new video.
A scandal review.
A scandal review. I actually want, I'm noticing I don't have one of anything scandal. I wanted to put on my B613 hoodie. I keep calling Kari, but she's not in. Kari!
At this point, you need a beat.
Because I'm cold, and I wanted to wear something scandal for the, because...
You got chicken's lipstick all over you.
This is my last time that I'll be able to wear them, because scandal will be going off, but...
Scandal? You never wearing your shirts again?
Yeah, but I mean, on the show. I mean, I can always wear them on the show, but right. Scandal reviews. I wanted to finish it off on all scandal.
Got you.
But, yeah, Scandal came on yesterday, and I have to tell you, you know, before watching it the second time... I wasn't upset, I just was like, I just wasn't feeling this episode. It probably was because it wasn't, that little boy is scaring me on Insidious. It's probably because it wasn't a lot of Liv in it, and I just didn't want to deal with Papa Pope and fucking Quinn. I just was irritated, like, I saw a lot of people saying it felt like a filler episode, but to me, there should be no filler episode because we're coming to the series.
Right.
Not season, series finale. Like, we don't have time for a filler episode. But after watching it the second time, it was okay. But I just still was upset. But, I know. If you notice, they show so many clips from previous episodes anyway. It's just like, Shonda... But anyway, we're reviewing,
You can't even sneak in me one snack. Damn!
We're reviewing episode 9, Good People. Funny title, shout out to Shonda. But this episode was really supposed to be showing us what happened as far as Quinn being kidnapped and up until leading into her death.
Her demise.
So it starts off and it goes right back to Charlie and Papa Pope tussling, fighting for the gun, and then it starts to show a bunch of flashbacks from the previous episodes of Liv and arguments and Quinn, like it's just a bunch of different, it's just shit going all over the place, and then we see Papa Pope. And Papa Pope is strolling through...
Yo, I don't know what's going on.
But why can't we just do the video?
I swear I don't know what this is.
You was just on Instagram, bitch.
Prove it.
So, Papa Pope is strolling through Sam's Club. And he stops in front of something. He's talking to a salesperson. And we come to find that he is buying luggage. Mm-hmm. And he's letting the man know that he needs something that is wide and big. Something that will fit all of the things that he needs to do. And he tells him that he's going on a big adventure.
Yeah, alright.
Next thing you know, we see Quinn. It's her wedding day. She's in her wedding gown. Heading for OPA elevator where the wedding is supposed to be being held. She's in the elevator. She seems happy. You know, it's her wedding day. Even though not too long before that, Liv had pissed her off. But...
children out of my house.
So then they when she's in the elevator, we see Papa Pope peeking in, and then they don't even show the whole kidnapping. They show Papa Pope walking out of the elevator fast with his suitcase with Quinn in it. Shonda, you're gonna have to do better than that.
Was it an expandable suitcase?
Shonda, you're going to have to do better than that.
There's
no way that he got Quinn's pregnant ass in that five. Maybe Liv, because she's this big.
Quinn? And then he was just strolling it. Like,
when y'all saw Quinn in the suitcase, what was y'all thinking? Because I know I was like, fuck.
I said, is she in the suitcase? And then I saw the hair.
So, y'all fucking tried it. So, Quinn wakes up in a basement. She's looking around. She's a bit confused. Like, what the fuck is going on? She notices her fucking leg is chained to the fucking wall. And she's just like, she's just... She kind of feels like she's in the Twilight Zone, and then the door opens and she realizes who has kidnapped her. It's Papa Pope. And you know, he's just telling her that the walls are soundproof and the door is some type of titanium. Yeah. And you know, she's like, because I think she had told him, like, my team is going to come looking for me.
Yeah.
And she was, and he was like, well, they think you got cold feet. And then they show the flashbacks of them seeing the ring, saying that Quinn ran. And Quinn is just like, shit. So, why are all these people messaging me? I don't know what's going on. So, she starts flipping out and she's like, did Liv send you? Because I found out what the fuck happened with her. I don't have time for this shit. I'm fucking 700 months pregnant. You got me chained to a fucking wall. My people are going to come fucking get me. I don't give a fuck what you talking about right now. Like, she's just going to fuck off on his old ass. And you know what? He ain't saying shit.
Because he know that.
He just standing there like.
He got it, man. You gotta get some things off her chest.
Okay. So he's like, she's like, no, mothers and children. Y'all, that's the rule for B613. You never hurt mothers and children. You can't hurt me. And she's just going up, going up, going up. He's just like, can you chill out for a second? I mean, my God, you are a part of B613. Like,
right.
Shouldn't be wilding like this. I thought you were stronger than this. Like, chill the fuck out. So, he basically lets her know that this is a trade-off. He has her in order to get his freedom back. She's his ticket to freedom, aka his bones. Like, that's my other thing. Yeah. Like, Shonda, where are you going with these fucking bones?
Because I don't understand why they... I mean, I understand, like, his love for dinosaurs and archaeology and all that type of shit, but to really make it as though Papa Pope is this crazy over some fucking bones...
Yeah, it's weird.
Like, it's weird.
It's getting really weird. Okay, Shonda. But yeah, so he's basically letting her know, you know, this is a trade-off. For my freedom, you're not going no fucking where. And he cut the fucking lights off and show her where the fuck the bathroom at and go back upstairs. I'm just like, damn, like, I mean, but this is the same man that I mean, she kind of lucky she ain't in the hole.
Hell yeah, but it's because she's pregnant.
Yeah, she lucky.
She better thank God for that baby.
So he goes, it goes back to the clip where him and Liv were at dinner, which we've already seen this entire clip, but it kind of has a different meaning. Like, you can really understand it now because we actually got to see Quinn.
Right.
Like, she comes in kind of, like, annoyed. Like, what the fuck do you want? Because they're looking for Quinn. Mm-hmm. But she didn't even know that he had him. So he's like, I have Quinn. Like, because she kind of was just about to leave. Like, what the fuck you want? I don't have time for this. He all telling her the night special and shit. She's like, uh-uh. So he like, I got Quinn. And he tell her, you know, give me my bones and I'll give you Quinn back. And she basically, like, calls his bluff, like, no, I'm still in control. You gonna sit the fuck down and do what the fuck I say and wait for when I want to give you your freedom back and your fucking bones. I don't believe you gonna do shit.
Because, but it's also, though, at this point, you have so many things to do. Like, you are so busy. Bitch, how long are you gonna keep him away from this dinosaur? It's like, okay, you already put your child in timeout. How long are they going to be in timeout? Like, girl, get over it.
I mean, but nobody has sympathy for Papa Pope because he's a fucking monster.
So is Olivia.
I mean, I'm just saying, but nobody gives a fuck about him being mad about bones. But at the same time, it's like,
that's why he should have killed Quinn.
I do think he should have killed Quinn.
I mean, I was sorry to see her go, But he definitely should have killed her ass.
That's what I was saying. It's not even a, y'all know I love Quinn. You know, years ago I wanted her to die, but recently I really love Quinn, and it's just like, I felt like, you know, y'all know how I be when a character died, but at this point I already kind of accepted that she might be dead, and plus I just feel like Shonda need to step this up a notch. I mean, if anybody should be dying, it should be Jake, but if she gotta kill Quinn off to hurt us, do it. Like, yes. Do something, Shonda. Series finale.
Yeah.
But anyway, so she keeps calling his bluff, and you know, she threatens him a little bit, and he let her know. He like, I'm just like, you know, I'm not playing. So you can think I'm fucking playing, but
he should have fucking killed her.
He should have, like,
thinking back, he should have fucking killed her.
I'm telling you, he should have killed her. So you know, he comes back from dinner and he goes straight to his fucking guns. Like, first he went to go get like his big gun, but then he was like, "Nah, let me go get this little one." He turned on a fucking and then as soon as he's about to go down the steps, he just like, "I'm not gonna do this shit today. I'm not gonna do it today. I'm not gonna do it today." Like, he screamed to the top of his lungs, like he wanna go kill her so bad.
Like, is this man really this crazy?
But it's like, why didn't you just do it?
Right.
That's my thing. Like, why didn't you just do it? So he go and he talk to, which this is something else annoying. This tiny fucking dinosaur. Like, Shonda, what is this?
Because it's Papa Pope. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's fucking Papa Pope, bitch.
He goes and talks to this tiny dinosaur, and he tells the dinosaur, like, I ain't no bitch. I'm gonna kill her in 3 fucking days. 3 motherfucking days.
His that exact bitch words. Is dead. That's his exact words. Well,
so, the next thing you know, this motherfucker goes crib shopping. He's back at Sam's Club.
He's back at Sam's Club
and he's looking for a fucking crib for his daughter. And you know, him and the salesperson have really gotten cool. The salesperson tells him which crib to get, because he's like, he really don't know what crib to get. He just wants to help his daughter.
Because at this point, I gotta keep up.
Right. So he comes back to the house. He goes in the basement. He has a bag with him. And, you know, she's just flipping out like, I need clothes. I need food. I'm fucking starving. Like, she's thinking that she's about to go, because she knows that he went and met up with Liv. Like, she's thinking it's go time. And he's like, you know, he's not responding. And it hits her like, oh my God. Liv said no. Like, Liv's gonna let me die. Like, she doesn't give a fuck about me. Like, what the?
I honestly hope that when we when they finally realize that Quinn is alive, Quinn kills Olivia. Like, what? You are one of my best fucking friends. You are the godmother of my child, bitch. And you want to play with my life over bones and my unborn child. I will fucking kill you, bitch.
And she, you know, he was just like, she said she needs a little more time, and she starts spazzing out. Like, don't you know what that means? That means she's beaten you already. She's already handled the situation. She's never gonna fucking give you the answer that you want now. Haven't you learned your daughter by now? Like, she's just like flipping the fuck out.
Fuck off on his ass.
So you know what the fuck he did? He rolled his eyes. He tossed her a tote bag, and he said, "There's some clothes and some cereal in there. I see you tomorrow."
Deuces.
Like, damn, Papa Pope. Cereal? I ain't even seen no milk in no bowl. Like, you just gave a box of fucking cereal.
Well, that's what he likes to eat.
Bitch, she's pregnant. When they went upstairs, he had a whole fucking table full of fruit. Give that bitch a couple of bananas. Damn.
Says the pregnant woman don't even eat fruit.
I'm just saying, she's fucking pregnant.
True. He could have gave her some bananas to go with the cereal.
Something? Damn, I'm just saying. So then it goes and it shows him and the sales. He actually was on. He went to the bar, which probably wasn't a coincidence. Now that I'm thinking about it,
nothing with him is a coincidence.
Yeah, he goes to the bar and he runs into the salesman again, the one that he's getting cool with. So you know, they start kikiing and talking over some chicken wings and some beer. They both realize that they were both, you know, they both served in, you know, the army, and they start talking about the different things they did. And then he's like, you know, if you ever whatever one to, you can use my 40% off discount.
That's what school. I call a motherfucking friend. Hello, 40%? That's close to 50.
Right.
Hello.
So he's like, no, I couldn't do that. Like, how does that even work? And he's just like, well, you know, I would take it and I would purchase it in myself. It would go in my name and it would be under my name, so I would have to purchase it for you, and then I would just give it to you. And every 40%, he's just like, nah, I don't know. He's like, seriously, like, if you need to use it, you can use it. Like, it's not a problem. And he's just like, well, you know, I could use some more stuff for my daughter. And he's just like, come on down and get what you need, bro.
Right.
I got you. I'm just like, oh, shit. Like, what the fuck?
He was stressed out.
I really was stressed the fuck out. It's just like, but it gives him, I think I missed something. No, I didn't miss it.
What?
I didn't get to it yet. He didn't get to Jake yet, right?
What do you mean?
To Jake.
Oh, when Jake.
No, I didn't get to Jake yet, but I thought that was what gave him the idea, like, it would be a good idea for him to use him for a gun. Because his gun wasn't gone yet, though.
Yeah, because I, No, when did Jake come?
No, it's after this, because I got it after this.
Oh, yeah.
But it's just like, I thought that was the reason. I mean, it really gave him the idea, like, well, shit.
Hold on. What part are you on?
I'm on when he was at the bar eating chicken wings with him.
Okay, so they was at the bar eating chicken wings or whatever. And then he comes home, and then there's Jake. And Jake's telling him, like, you really shouldn't go through with this, blah, blah, blah. She's a different person. He's like, I don't give a fuck. I will kill that bitch. And then he's like, well, she's going to be more prepared than what you think she is. And then that triggers something in his head. He goes and looks for his fucking shit, and he knows that it's no guns.
Right, I know that, but I thought that had happened before, like, but...
It happened later on.
Yeah.
And then he went and asked him for the gun at the store.
Right, okay, so before we get to that, so after he leaves and he lets him know about all of that shit, we get back to Quinn, and, you know, she's just in the basement, and she's just sitting, rocking back and forth, and then next thing you know, she sees Charlie appear in the corner. She's starting to imagine things. You know, he's sucking on his sugar. You know, he got a sugar fucking addiction. And,
I didn't know what you was about to say he was sucking on. I was scared. I didn't know where this was going.
And he's just like, she's like, no, it's not real. Like, she just hurry up and close the eyes. She opens it, and he's gone. And she's just like, she's feeling something. She's like, oh, my God. Kick, kick, kick. Like, she realizes she hasn't really felt the baby kick. And then the baby kicks, and she's just like, thank God. And I'm just like, shit, because... at this point, the baby could be fucking dead.
Oh, my God.
For real? All the fucking stress and trauma? Shit. I mean, she was in a fucking suitcase.
That shit is crazy. Why does he think he could put a pregnant lady in a suitcase?
So...
he must have did it before.
That's when we get to what Tanea was talking about when, he goes to the car to talk to Jake, and he's just like, you know, you can save this convo. And he's like, I'm not even... here for that. He's like, I'm basically here to warn you that, you know,
this bitch is crazy.
Liv is crazy. You don't know her like you think you know her, and she will win this. She's going to win this. And he said, you might not be as prepared as you think you are.
No, he said she's more prepared than you think she is.
Yeah. So that like clicks something in his head, and he go in the house and he realizes that all of his guns are gone, and then he goes and he talks to the tiny dinosaur and
is that where the camera is in the tiny dinosaur?
Yeah, the camera is in the tiny dinosaur. What the fuck did he say to the dinosaur this time?
He went the fuck off. I do remember that. He started like screaming.
Yeah, he said a couple of
she will respect me.
Yeah, he said
you
a couple
will
of
fear me. Like he went the fuck crazy. He did a poem, I think.
Yeah, he did a couple of two famous quotes. To the dinosaur on like two different parts. I do remember that. And then we go back downstairs to Quinn, and you know, she's singing, you are my sunshine, my only sunshine. Like, she's really starting to lose it. And then she sees Huck. And Huck just starts going in on her ass, like, why are you not doing nothing? Like, this is definitely not you. You should be doing something to save yourself. Like, get the fuck up and do something. I don't give a fuck if you pregnant, bitch. I don't give a fuck if you depressed. Get the fuck up and do something. And then he also is like flipping out on her about not telling. Like, he's like, why when you found out about what Liv did, you didn't say something to somebody? Like, we could have fixed this. We could have handled this. That you have to go this far. And she, you know, she finally responds and she's just like, because I wanted to give Liv the benefit of the doubt. Like, I didn't want to believe that she is the monster that clearly she really fucking is. Like, it's Liv. Like, I really wanted to give her a fucking chance. And Huff looking at her like, well, bitch,
fuck her.
You please.
You gave her a chance and now you about to die.
Self. You played your motherfucking self.
You did.
I don't know why I have crib for the baby right here. I don't think this was the part when he told her he got a crib. I don't think it is. But okay, so this is when he goes back to Sam's Club. And he's like, he wants to get a gun. Like, he's like, can you get
is
a...
Is this Sam's Club?
No, it's called something else, warehouse. But it's Sam's Club. It's Sam's Club. It's a warehouse, bitch.
It's Walmart.
It's not. It's a warehouse.
You can't buy guns at Sam's
Club. It's Boss Call. So it'd be Costco or BJ's.
You can't buy guns at
You don't know that.
You can only buy guns at Walmart.
So, I'm going to start here. So he goes and...
Are you yawning?
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
So he goes and he asks her, he asks the salesman, can he get a gun? And he's just like,
whoa, hold on here, nigger. Okay? Calm the fuck down, all right, Blackie?
He didn't.
It's the hell up.
He didn't say all of that. But he was just like,
he was thinking it. Because I was like,
whoa, wait, like, I don't, you know, I'm really not comfortable with that. He's like, why do you need a gun? And he's just like, to protect my family. He was like, I'm going to have a baby in the house now. I need to protect my family.
But the thing is, Papa Pope doesn't even realize that he looks like a crazy person. He's literally in the middle.
And he's bugged out.
Random as fuck. You bugged out. You look all perturbed.
Yes.
Your sweater's all fucked up.
And he's sweating too. And he's just like, he asked him, you know, don't you have a gun? He was like, well, yeah. He was like, he has a gun. He's like, you know, why don't you want me to get one? Like,
well,
why
you, can't you I don't think one? I should have the same shit? I said, oh, race cars.
He was like, we both have red, white, and blue running through our veins. I'm like, boy, what the fuck? But it was like Papa Pope had completely flipped it to make him feel like, why shouldn't I have a gun? Like, if you have a gun, why can't I have a gun?
Right.
Bitch, in the end, it was like Shonda had kind of slid that gun control shit in there. Because the white man started to say shit, too. Like, he was saying something like, we have a right to protect ourselves.
He was like, we have a right to protect our family.
Yeah. And basically, Shonda was sliding in and showing you how easy it is for people to get a gun.
Yeah.
Like, just like that, he could get somebody else to get it in their name, and it was that easy for him to get a gun. That, and he, not only did he get the gun, he got it 40% off.
Yeah.
40% off. This is happening in real life, people.
It is. That's why white people are getting and going in and shooting up shit.
Y'all voted for Donald Trump. It wasn't me. So, then when he comes back from getting the ammo, he talks into the dino again. And that's when you see Jake in the bunker. And Jake's like, Jake calls Liv and he's like, he lets her know that he has more ammo. Like, he went out and got... Because not only did he get one gun, he got two fucking guns.
How did he got two?
He got two. He got the long one and he got the short one because he was about to get the short one. And he was like, you should get this one.
Oh, yeah.
He was like, this is the big one. Like, if you really want to do some damage. This is really happening, people.
It is really happening.
Y'all voted for Donald Trump. Maryland didn't vote for him. And the black women didn't either. So, we good over here.
Yeah. I mean,
we go over here. So that's when Liv comes over, and that was the whole conversation from the last episode when, you know, they're just going back and forth. Papa Pope gets the gun in her face. She calls him a bluff. She's like,
he should have shot her.
No, he shouldn't have
right
shot
in her fucking clavicle. Bam, bitch! Give me my fucking bones! Or there goes the pinky toe.
He was about to shoot her in her head.
He should have just shot off her fucking limbs, her fingers, one by one. Ripped out her eyelashes, poked in the kneecaps with an ice pick, ripped out her teeth, snatched off her fucking wig, all types of shit.
I'm disgusted right now today.
Huh?
So, him and Liv are having that same conversation, going back and forth. And, you know, she's basically calling him a bluff, and she's like, I see your chewy inner, what's she say?
Your chewy inner self, or
your chewy center is showing. Like, she was just like, you know, your mushy side is showing. You know what?
He should have popped and hit her with a gun. Chewy inside that bitch.
So, he's like, she's like, yeah, like, I don't give a fuck what you say. I'm not doing shit. So she started doing a fucking countdown. Meanwhile, the whole crew was in the basement, like Quinn done imagined.
Everybody.
Abby's there, Marcus is there, Huck is there, Charlie's there. And she's like putting together, like, I think pieces from her dress, I feel like.
Yeah.
To try to rope, make it into a rope to get these two boxes, to get the boxes to see if there's anything in there to help her get unchained and to save herself. But when she finally does get the boxes, it's nothing in there.
Totally empty.
It's nothing in the box.
Not a thing to help her.
So, Papa Pope, this is, remember, Liv has done the countdown, so now she's at 5, 4, 3, 2. Papa Pope starts walking. And remember, this is how it went off the last season. Liv heard was the gunshot, so we actually get to see him go to the basement. He goes to the basement. Soon as he gets down to the basement, Quinn is unhooked, and she has a chain, like
the chain that she was fucking wrapped up with.
She has a chain, and she tries to choke him, but he has his hand up, and when he pulls away, it slices his hand open, so it makes him make a mistake and shoot the gun off. So that was the first gunshot we heard, and then he kind of like pushes her, like, real hard into the fucking
apartment, lady.
Hard as I was surprised she had a baby
she
right then.
That fucking baby, honestly.
So that's when he puts the gun to her face, and she's just like, no, no, please, 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 just wait for the baby to be born. I don't have that much longer. Please, please, please. And then he just shoots it, and it goes commercial. When it comes back, we see that he shot at the fucking wall. And
right,
like,
but no, not only at the wall, literally 5 centimeters from her face on the wall.
But the thing is, Shonda, do it. Fucking do it, y'all. Like, I'm not saying that I want Quinn to be dead, but I'm just saying, do it. Like, do it. Like, Shonda, you gotta take this shit up a notch. What is you doing? All of this for nothing.
Oh, no, baby. What is you doing?
I'm so fucking annoyed. So, that's when, he goes upstairs and he's talking to Liv, and Liv is just, you know, she's a little shaken up, and she's just like, you know, he's like, you want to see the body? And she's like, no. She was like, but wait a few days, and because we're going to need the body, because Huck is going to look for her, and he's never going to stop until he finds her.
True.
So you do still need to, you know, show up with the body so we can bury her. But it really just made, that was the moment that I was just like, damn. Like, Liv, you really did this.
Right.
Because see, Liv really thinks she's dead. Like, Liv!
You really did.
You killed Quinn. Like, you really chose your pride.
You're best friends.
Damn. Oh.
Tiffany, don't kill me.
I will kill you.
Don't make a decision to kill me.
I will kill you.
Think about me and how much think about me and how much our friends love me. And my family loves me.
Your family don't love you.
Are you fucking kidding me? My family loves me. I'm the apple of their fucking eye.
Girl, get the fuck off of me. So yeah, but it just, in that moment, I was just like, damn, like, Liv really is trash for this shit.
She really is a trash box. Shit.
So then it goes back to the flash on how Quinn got out of the chain. And the hairpin that Liv gave her is what saved her. That's how she got the chain off of her her ankle.
Liv to save me, but she already has.
Right. So in that flashback, when he did decide not to shoot her, he told her to be quiet. So she actually heard everything when she was telling him to, you know, wait a couple days because we're gonna need the body because we gotta bury it. And it really just made her feel like, damn, like, Liv really don't give a fuck
about me.
Like, she really is gonna let this man
kill me.
Like, she actually thinks I'm dead right now, and it's nothing to her. Like, just say, make sure you save the body. Liv, you know I love you.
She better be a hate person for the day.
But so then,
did last week.
Then this motherfucker going off of Quinn some wine. She like, I'll take some water. But Simone let us know last night that now pregnant women can drink wine.
Well, I thought it, cause I was, and what's to, expect when you're expecting? Mm-hmm. It says that it is okay for you to drink a glass of red wine. But
I didn't know it was that far along though. She like 9 months.
Let me Google it. Can you drink water?
But anyway, so while they're upstairs having their wine and water, Quinn, you know, starts to feel labor pains, but she thinks it's just Braxton Hicks. But come to find out, she's really going into labor because her water breaks, and she's like freaking out, like, you gotta take me to the hospital. And he's just like, no, you're gonna be fine. We're gonna have an old-fashioned birth. And Quinn starts freaking out, like, no, no, like, please, 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 please. Like, she just starts flipping out. And then, I didn't even see this last night, put a fucking needle in her neck.
Mm-hmm.
And put the bitch out. I said, damn. So she passed out. Next thing you know, she wake up. She's looking around. Vision is blurry. We see the fucking salesman again. He's there helping Papa Pope deliver this fucking baby, bitch. It's weird. Because at first I thought the salesman was B613. I'm not even gonna lie to you. But at this point, she's really delirious now from the shot. So the whole team is there and they're just helping her, you know, telling her to push. Charlie's there telling her everything's going to be okay. She pushes, the baby comes out, and then she passes back out. She wakes up. She wakes up in a room, Liv's old bedroom, and Papa Pope is holding the baby.
His grandbaby.
Like a proud granddad.
Yeah.
Humming and shit. I'm like, what the fuck is this? Like, Shonda, for all of this, if he want to be a fucking grandfather, ship us to fucking Vermont and let's get this shit over with. Let's get Liv pregnant and get this shit popping, bitch. You already killed that first baby, the Silent Night. I can't even listen to that shit at Christmas time no more. Mm. The fuck is you doing? Shonda is a twisted individual, yo. I don't care. She's sick, yo. And the crazy thing is, you can see so much of Meredith and Olivia. And even though she's not the number one writer like she is on Grey's and Scandal on How to Get Away with Murder, you can see a lot of Annalise, like, you can see a lot of each other in all three of them, and it lets me know that that's what Shonda like. I'm telling you. The girl. So, I'm just holding the baby. She sees clothes and she sees that the baby has a diaper on and stuff, and you know, she's just like, damn, like, you got the baby all dressed and shit. Like, I didn't even know I had supplies and shit. Like, thanks. And he lets her know, you know, you can't go home right now. And she's just like, yeah, because clearly she's supposed to be dead. And he's like, well, I'm about to go ahead downstairs and, you know, clean up. And she's like, you're a good person. And he's just like, you know, well, thank you. You know, he went on his Eric Badu shit. It's good in everybody. Thank you for seeing it.
Well, that's what the man said to him.
What?
His white friend, Marty.
Oh, what did he say?
He said, everyone's good when you give them a chance.
Yeah.
Everybody can do some good when you give them a chance to be.
You're so observant. What would I do without you?
I honestly don't know.
So, we're at the end, and, you know, she's just, you know, looking at her child, rock by baby. And she's looking at the clothes that Rowan got.
Are they boys' clothes?
They're boys' clothes, but it's because they're dinosaurs. And you know he likes dinosaurs.
He's a sicko.
Right. So as she's looking at the clothes, mind you, they're Granimals from Walmart. I get them for Rex.
Told you he was at the Walmart getting the gun.
Nah, that was Sam's
clothes. That's the same place? Shut up.
As she's looking at the clothes, she notices that a lot of the shirts are the same, but they go up sizes, and they go all the way to a 24-month, which means you trying to keep me for 2 fucking years, nigga. What the fuck is going on
see,
here?
See, at first, my dumb ass, I'm like, oh, he got all the sizes because he didn't know what size the baby was going to be.
Bitch. He ain't stupid. You think Mama Pope was taking care of Olivia?
I know.
He knew
exactly.
He knew exactly what the fuck he was doing. So she go running downstairs, and when she get downstairs, she see the salesman on the floor dead in a puddle of blood.
Head open. I think I saw his brain on the
ground. I saw something. It was something.
I think it was his brain. Did he, like, slice his brain open? Like, what happened?
So she's just like, you're a monster. you ain't shit. What the fuck? What the hell is going on? And he's just like, I had to do it. You said no mothers and children. Like, what the fuck was I supposed to do? I was following the rules, so he had to fucking go.
Right.
About her being a B613 agent herself, she's just like,
she knew. It was nothing else to say. She got to scrub.
She just got down with the baby, scrubbing the floor with Fabuloso, the newborn baby, inhaling all the fucking cleaning products. The baby came into the world crazy. He done already seen a fucking death.
Dead body.
And now he's sniffing fucking poison. You know what? So like I said, like, it wasn't a horrible episode, but it was just like,
I needed more.
It wasn't exciting. Like, I just, whatever. Like, I'm not upset. I'm just like,
I need more.
When they showed that flash the next week, y'all know I'm super excited. But let me tell y'all what one of my favorite viewers sent me. She called herself sending me some notes, which is good, girl, because I be needing notes. But she gave me a list and she said, how did Jake find the bunker when he broke it? Why didn't Jake find the bunker when he broke to the house? But I'm thinking he didn't, because it looks like
Jake didn't find the bunker, because remember, the keypad is behind Snack.
Yeah.
Because it doesn't look like anything. It literally looks like his regular kitchen.
Right.
Because Jake's lived with him.
Yeah.
So if Jake's lived there, he doesn't know that that bunker, because trust me, he didn't just start building it.
Right.
That shit was built in the house.
Mm-hmm.
He's had it for years.
Mm-hmm.
It's probably just one of the secrets that he never let him have.
Yeah. With good reason, because him and Papa Pope are always on and off.
Yeah, you just never know.
Said the camera was still in the dinosaur, so why didn't it pick up Quinn's voice? That's a good question.
Now, that's what I also want to know.
Really good question, but of course, we gotta just be like, oh, it's TV.
Yeah.
Quinn heard Liv. Oh, she's like, you know, Quinn heard Liv say everything. I said that Papa Pope couldn't shoot Quinn. Maybe he didn't want to be responsible for another one of Liv's friends dying.
Right, because he killed her. Person.
How long was Papa Pope planning on keeping Quinn's baby?
At this point, 24 months. Because that's what the clothes said.
You know, he probably don't never want her ass to move out.
I was about to say, but also he didn't kill her because you're not supposed to kill women and children.
Right. And she also said, did you see Shonda slid the gun issue in there and played the race? Yes. Played the race card so that we could see that it happens all the time. And Papa Pope wouldn't have had a gun if Jake didn't run his mouth. True that.
That's true.
Yeah. So, yeah, it was an okay episode. It was all
right. See, my thing is, I don't understand why Olivia didn't follow him when she called his bluff. Oh, I want to see you.
Mm-hmm.
I want to see you shoot him. Oh, since you said you got it, I want to see her.
Because she's the ex and she want to see the
body. At that point, he would have really killed her.
Yeah. Yeah.
If she would have went down there, he really would have killed her.
So, my love person is Quinn. My hate person is Papa Pope.
Bitch, you are ignorant ass piece of shit. You cannot give Olivia the shit that she deserves. She is a fucking villain. You need to give her that. Give her the hate person. Olivia Pope is the hate person of the show.
Liv,
she is the show's hate person for the night.
Liv was barely in this episode, so I can't give her.
The reason why this was an episode is because of her. You literally said it out your mouth. This is because of Liv and her pride and her ego. Why can't you give her the hate person? Like, damn. If it was me, you could give me the hate person. Why Liv can't get the hate person? It's because you can't be honest and you can't be real with yourself.
You want something sick, girl?
So she was standing at the door, so I was seeing if she wanted to.
Nene is going downhill. You hear her voice? But yeah, so y'all make sure y'all send me comments. Let me know if I missed anything. Let me know how you felt about this episode. I feel like since next week we about to get some lit. We finally, which I don't know why we had to wait until season fucking 7 to get an intervention for Olivia. We needed that shit back in season 3.
Well, she's at her worst now.
We want to wait until the show about to go off.
She's literally at her worst. She needs an intervention. Like, the bitch is is the command.
Yeah, and I was really happy about her being excited about going to Vermont. So I see, you know, her going to go see
him.
She
gonna kill him. See, now this is not gonna fuck up their chances. She gonna kill his ass.
No, I think she gonna get over it. Because it's gonna be for the best, because she needs this. Okay. She needs this. But like I said, you guys make sure you comment. Let me know what you thought of the video. Let us know what we missed. Let me know who you enjoyed this episode. And I will see you guys next week. We will actually be recording on Thursday night.
Now that he got the bones, is he going to let her free?
Well, I don't know what he is, because you remember he didn't already playing in a fake body.
Right, but now it doesn't matter because he has his bones. Like, he had what he wanted.
Yeah.
So when is she going to be able to walk out this house?
I don't know. Okay. If this is your first time watching, make sure you subscribe. We'll be here every Friday with an all-new scandal review. For the people who have been watching, make sure you share this video. Tell a friend to tell a friend. Tell your mother, your cousin, your sister, your brother. Tell somebody about the show. And I'll see you guys next week for some Olets. I'm wearing my Olet shirt. Do I got an Olets hat?
No. And if you didn't know, now you know there's no show like the show where Timothy doesn't like to be truthful on this bitch. Okay? We gotta go. See y'all next week.
Yo, Khadijah is trash.
Well,
this bitch gonna say.